Alright folks, today we are smoking Menemen with Sucuk and Feta Cheese. Time to grow. For my viewers who have been watching the whole last year, I had so much fun with different recipes, basically with the same ingredients. So we made shakshuka, traditional recipe from Israel and North African people. I made huevos rancheros, the Mexican version of more or less the same idea. We made uovo in purgatorio, which is the Italian version, and today I proudly present the Turkish version. This is menemen, kind of Turkish egg dish served for breakfast. We're gonna get started with dicing medium-sized yellow onion and red bell pepper. So these are two red bell peppers we are preparing today. We're gonna slice this one. So this does not mean to be the original recipe of anything. This is more or less my interpretation. I did some research on the internet with different recipes, and same with the huevos rancheros and all the other dishes I mentioned. This is just my own personal interpretation. I hope you're having fun with that. So we're gonna get the bell pepper sliced thinly. If you're not able to slice this one as thin as I, it's of course fine. So then we need some spring onions, but we only need the darker green part. This is for the last step of the menemen. This is sucuk. Sucuk is kind of a Turkish sausage with a lot of garlic in there. I really like this one. It has a nice flavor and it helps to get the garlic flavor into our meat, so we don't need extra garlic here. Of course, I will put an exact amount of ingredients into the video description as always. You can check it out there and you can just take this and start cooking this awesome recipe by yourself. There are also some interesting links in the video description, so don't forget to check it out. So after dicing the sucuk sausage, there are only two more ingredients missing. The first one, tomato. So if you do the research on the internet on how this works, the normal Turkish recipe takes fresh tomatoes, they peel it and then they slice them thinly. Due to the fact that the tomatoes in Germany have not the quality for me as in the origin of the recipe, I decided to take the canned tomatoes because they are much riper and less bitter. So we decided to take two cans of tomato. Then we need four eggs. So four fresh eggs, and we're gonna season this with a salt and pepper mixture. And then we're gonna break the egg yolk a little bit, just like so. And then we are ready with the whole preparation thing. We can take our cast iron pan, that's where we prepare it in. We're gonna get outside to the grill. So I prepared the Breuking Keg Kamado cooker for direct heat today. I add the cast iron pan, lots of olive oil, and then we add the onions and the sucuk into the cold pan so it can heat up with the olive oil and the cast iron. This makes the onion a little bit more sweet. And so just close the lid and let this one heat up for approximately 5 to 10 minutes. It depends a little bit on the amount of charcoal you use, but you can see now that it starts cooking right now. Just close the lid again and let that one again heat up for another 5 till 10 minutes, just like so. And then we are able to add the sliced bell pepper here. And what we like to do now is soften the bell pepper, and we're trying not to burn the onions and the sucuk, so it's still not the highest heat. This is a smooth way of cooking this one, We're gonna let that soften a little bit and let it cook for another 5 till 10 minutes. After that, we're gonna add some balsamic vinegar here. It adds also some nice flavor and gets a little bit of freshness. Immediately add the tomato and we're gonna let this cook for another 15 minutes or so. You can smash the peeled tomatoes. That's fun for me. And then we can close the lid. And as I mentioned, let that cook for another 15 minutes or so. So first break for today. Go and get yourself a nice drink, have a beer, and let that cook for some minutes. So almost done. In the meantime, I forgot to film adding salt and pepper. So almost last step is adding the eggs and mix it a little bit with the tomato. And the final step is add the feta cheese. These are approximately 200 grams of feta cheese. If you're not into feta cheese, you can use any other cheese you like. For me, sucuk and feta is the perfect combination for this dish, but feel free to use any other things you like. So as I mentioned in the beginning, we're trying to smoke this one. So for the last 15 or 20 minutes or so, we're gonna add some olive seeds here to add some smoke to the charcoal. And we close the lid, we close the vents, and all we have to do is wait for the feta cheese and for the egg to be done. So we're gonna smoke this one. I will show you after 5 or 7 minutes or so that we still have a way to go here. The egg yolk is not complete hard. So close the lid again, and this is actually what I was looking for. So we have some nice color, and we add the spring onions. And for me, this looks really, really awesome. So you can add now some fresh bread here. I use sesame bread. You can use any bread you like, of course, but this one is really, really cool. So to my Turkish friends, teşekkür ederim, acıktım, afiyet olsun. I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Would be really cool if you could check this out and grill this by yourself. So here's what I do after grilling. You might have seen this before. Some really great German liquor with nice funny comments on this. This one is called Hackfresse, which is kind of, you have to Google that. I won't tell you, but it has to do something with your face. So, and now we're gonna do something I haven't done for years. We're gonna put this one into our beer. We're gonna drink this one. And this is fun. So today we put the Hackfresse into our beer. And what does this make? After you have finished your beer, the last one mixes up with the liquor. Really nice flavor, fun to do. Would be really cool if you could subscribe, hit that like button, thumbs up. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.